long and in. Girardi takes it there, put it off the stick of Pouliot back as far as Beaulieu. Rushed by Zuccarello, the pass is tipped along, kept by the Rangers in deep. Zuccarello pushed it behind. Pouliot got it there. Around behind again off Zuccarello. Zuccarello's shoulder there by Pouliot. Pouliot getting it with a little over 2.5 to go and a save made by Tokarski. Around behind, brushed on by Bouillon, taken by Gallagher, outletted to Pacioretty, off the shoulder of McDonough, who recovered to Zuccarello. And on now for Brassard! Save made by Tokarski, and the force of it would have knocked him over had he not been prepared for that one.
Well, Derek Brassard scored on a similar type of play back in game four. And Tokarski was really aggressive. I mean, he's well out on top of the blue paint, and that's where one of those where you fake, you put your head down, and you keep going, because the goaltender's not going to be able to recover. Another big-time stop, and we send out a lot about Tokarski here in game six.
What a story. You remember back to that play Eddie was talking about. It was high, and it was high ball to side. That one hit him right in the breadbasket.
13 shots to 3 Rangers, 9 chances to none in this period, Rangers. Ash turns. The persistent work of Subban. Plekanec reaching in. The muscle work on the board. Plekanec fed one that bounced back where Stahl has to retreat. 2:05 left. And icing against the Rangers, so the faceoff will come back near Lundqvist.
The pressure by Thomas Vanek there forced Mark Stahl to make a hard play on the boards. As a Ranger player, you don't want to make any soft plays anywhere on the ice. If you ice it, you ice it. But Vanek forced Stahl to make a play, and the Canadians get a faceoff 200 feet away from their own zone.
Another one of those makeshift lines, Briere, Eller, and Bork.
If Briere wins it, he's going to try to get it to Markov, to Subban for a one-timer.
Pushed along to Strahlman. Played on for Nash, but away from him and down. And another icing.
Got to start thinking about the goaltender being pulled for the Canadians.
He's doing it now, Eddie.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
He's doing it now.
Buck 53 left to go, the extra attacker on the ice. And with only 3 shots on goal in the third period, you know why Michel Therrien is getting this aggressive.
Desharnais and Stepan. Strahlman wiped out. Tries to play it again, it's up the boards, rushing along as Subban touched it to Desharnais. Then to the back, Markov. Flung one that went wide, bounce free. Taken by Pacioretty, to the back to Markov again. Shoveled one that went wide. Taken again by Galchenyuk. Floated on again for Gallagher. Gallagher bodied, but he got it on back. Markov pushes to Subban. Subban floats it behind. Taken there, and then roughed up was Desharnais. Jabbed on for Gallagher. Away from Nash to Markov. Markov sent it for Pacioretty, and the shot by Gallagher is gonged up out of play by Lundqvist.
The Rangers did a good job of keeping the Canadians to the outside, but the puck got to the middle of the ice. Pacioretty with a beautiful pass to Brendan Gallagher, and you're right, Doc, gonged by Henrik Lundqvist.
Timeout, Montreal, men.
Timeout, Montreal.
If you consider, training camp was in September. Several of the players on both teams not only got to the first part of February, then traveled 9 time zones from the Eastern time zone away to play in Russia and to come back and to go rocking down the home stretch and then into these long series of the playoffs and maybe one last time out for Montreal in the year.
Well, you see both sides with the dry erase board. We saw Jerry Gallant, the assistant coach for the Canadians, with it out, and there you see Ulfi Samuelsson, assistant coach for Alain Vigneault, going over reminders what teams like to do when their goaltenders are out, but again, subtle reminders. A, what do we do when we win it? And B, if we don't, how do we respond and how do we defend? But most importantly, how do we check in our own zone?
Desharnais and Stepan. Off the tie-up. Puck winds up underneath. They jam away at it. Taken by Pacioretty. Markov is shot into the glove of Lundqvist. And again, play stop. That took 7 seconds.
One of those 50-50 pucks. Just hanging around the faceoff circle. It's dropped. Nobody can get it. The battle level. And then a simple little play back to the point. Nobody in front. Lundqvist does the right thing by holding on to it.
Desharnais and Stepan again, and it's one on back now for Markov. Got it to Pacioretty, and the shot flew out the glass. Jabbed at by Subban. He retreats and plays it again. Gallagher's shot that went wide. Chased down by Desharnais. Pulls it free. Rushed there by Dominic Moore. Got it along to Pacioretty. Touch back up the board. Subban. He delays and plays on, and around goes. It's tipped away by Girardi. Swatted on by Stepan. And at center, Gallagher dives and pokes it across, and Subban gave it back to him. Now to the last 38. Played along now by Bork and cleared as far as center. Popped out of play into the Rangers bench. Where will the faceoff be is the question.
Right in center ice stop. Right at the center ice stop.
Do you bring the goaltender back for that?
If you have to.
Halfway, right, Eddie?
Yeah, have him top of the circle. But it looks like he's not moving a muscle.
This is so important for Plekanec. He cannot lose this draw clean.
That's a trust factor in your center iceman, knowing he's going to win this draw for you.
Encroachment. These are the two best in faceoff percentage in the series. Kicked along, and Markov shovels it back. Wide of the cage, drilled along by McDonough. Ricocheted off Subban, gloved down by Eller to Galchenyuk, but a hand pass is ruled with 22 and a half to go.
Faceoff comes outside on that.
I know there's a little basketball that's played here at MSG, but Alex Galchenyuk, he caught for traveling. He's got it, he holds it, he holds it, and then he drops it.
So Desharnais and Dominic Moore. Moore has won about two out of three of these during the series from Desharnais. But will he get this one? The most important of all. They are breathing down their necks, and now it takes place. McDonough touched it across. Lobbed all the way back down, and Subban will turn and flex it out. Stopped by Boyle, and kicked loose by Markov. He's shaken up on the play. McDonough in the last eight. McDonough able to play it back out. Subban there. The Rangers are going to the final. But now the handshake line begins. PK Subban is at the very front of it, and you see him congratulating Marty St. Louis. Brandon Frost broke Derek Stepan's jaw 7 days ago.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand by for the official presentation of the... Prince of Wales.
Eventually they will meet.
Eastern Conference champion, New York Rangers.
And it will be interesting if we have the opportunity to see the goalies. It is very hard to choreograph this, and there they are.
And the respect factor there, Doc, for Dustin Tokarski from Marty St. Louis.
Entering tonight, he had 12 shots on him and some remarkable saves. Marty St. Louis continues to be part of an interesting story here in a renovated team that changed its whole character, seemingly, in the last 21 days. Now they get to wait. Now they get some time off.
Just a dominating performance, Doc, tonight, checking-wise by the New York Rangers.
Prince of Wales trophy to the Eastern Conference champion, New York Rangers. To accept the trophy are alternate captains, Brad Richards, Dan Girardi, and Mark Staal.
There is a superstition about the conference trophy. Some will pick it up and carry it off. Others won't touch it. Perhaps by the lead of Nick Lidstrom, who was a no-touch guy many times in Detroit when they won it. No fingerprints to brush off tonight. The chant is, we want the cup. They are one of two contenders. They were 1-1 against Los Angeles, 2-0 against Chicago a long time ago in the regular season.